praise the Lord. Last video, we ended with that thought that God has chosen us, and that is for a purpose. God has redeemed us. He has given us a new peace, a new hope, a new life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus himself says that I am the way, the truth, and the life. Praise the Lord. So what does that mean? That means that the world is a dead end. It is all lies and it leads to death. That is why Jesus came, to save you from death, to show you the truth, that to show you that there is an eternal life. Beyond this world, there is an eternal life. God is preparing a home for you. But remember from where you came out of? Do you remember that? You came out of that city of destruction. Hallelujah. What is the world? It is a dead end. It is a lie. And it is leading to death. This city of destruction is from where you escaped. This city of destruction is from where Jesus chose you. But do you think they will just leave you easily? No, you have three enemies. Hallelujah. The devil, the world, and your own flesh. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What do they want to do with you? Now, what do they want to do with you? Before, they just... they didn't care, you are with the world also, but now what do they want to do with you? Hallelujah. To make you fall back into that pit of sin, praise the Lord. To take away your new hope and peace, hallelujah. That new hope, that new peace that you received from God, that hope of eternal life, that peace that surpasses all understanding, that new life, that new creation that you are, they want to take it back and throw you back into that pit of sin, into that destruction again. Hallelujah. Psalms chapter 23 verse 1 and 2. We know it all by heart. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. Praise the Lord. This is till where I want to tell you. I want to tell you that if you see from the life of Lot, you know who is Lot? Abraham's nephew. Hallelujah. We see when it came to the time for him to decide where to go, left or right, he chose with his own eyes. It is nothing is written there about the Lord helping him or he inquiring from the Lord, Lord, where should I go? Nothing like that. Hallelujah. His own flesh was the Lord at that moment. We can see that he chose that land which he saw was green. He thought that will be a place of peace and prosperity, but it was not. This first verse, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. What does that mean? Peace. Hallelujah. God is giving you peace. You do not want. Hallelujah. You do not feel like you lack something. Hallelujah. But that is exactly what Lot wanted. Lot saw the green pasture. Lot wanted peace. Lot wanted prosperity. But where he went was not where God wanted him to go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God was not his shepherd at that point. His own flesh became his shepherd. And he went there. And we see that that was an evil place. Sodom and Gomorrah. And that city was destroyed by God. That city was not a place for peace for him. They troubled him a lot. Hallelujah. And another person, King Asa in the Bible, he trusted in a foreign king, and we see that he did not gain victory. Hallelujah. In Genesis chapter 15 verses 5 to 6, we see that God says to Abraham a promise. This 100-year-old Abraham, God is telling this promise, you know, look at the sky, look at the stars. And Abraham started, and God said, count how many stars are there. You know, he started 1, 2, 3, 10, 100, 1,000, lakh, and all this counting, but it was uncountable for him. And God said, this is how much, like this, your generations will be. You'll be a father of nations. And he believed. But in the next chapter, Genesis chapter 16 verse 2, we see that Sarai tells him, you bear a son from Hagar. But that was not God's will. Nothing about God's will is written over there. Hallelujah. So what does that mean? Sarai wanted fast results. Hallelujah. So we also see in Job's life, his wife came and told, curse God and die. What does this world want? Fast results. They want to come and tell you that even though you know that I have received a new life, I'm a new creation, I have received new peace, new joy, but they say to you earthly things. They say to you, where is your success? Where is the money? Where is the house? Where is the car? Where is this? And just like fast food and fast delivery, they are ready to tell everything fast. Every fast opinion they will tell. But not even Dettol can guarantee 100%. Hallelujah. So this world, they will be ready to tell you fast opinions. Oh, that God, yeah, why are you trusting him? You should do something yourself. You should think and do, where is your success and all, so that they may make your faith less, and you may forget about your peace, your joy, and the promises that God has given you. You may forget that and come back to that. Come back to the worldly thinking. But hallelujah, we should not go into their schemes. We should not fall into their traps. Hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11. We all know this, that his plans are not for our harm, but for our prosperity. Hallelujah. God is a faithful God. We can trust him. That's why God says, trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding. Commit your way to the Lord. Wait patiently on the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Psalms chapter 38 verse 9, it is written that your desires are not hidden from God. Hallelujah. Psalms 34 verse 37 verse 4 says that delight yourself in the Lord, and hallelujah, he will, hallelujah, and remember that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Hallelujah. Why? In Proverbs chapter 29 verse 5, it says that to fear man becomes a snare. It becomes a snare. We feel many times that this world will give the right opinions, but no, it is all a snare. They cannot guarantee anything. But trust in the Lord, hope in the Lord. God has told that if you trust in him, he will guide your paths. Hallelujah. He will guide your paths. He said, do not worry, your future is safe in my hands. Praise the Lord. Are you ready to trust the Lord? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It was not when Peter looked at Jesus that he started drowning. It was when he looked at his surroundings, when he saw the storm, when he saw the wind and the waves and everything, that time he started sinking. So if you see around you all these problems, all the opinions of people, then you may sink. Then you may sink. You cannot put your feet on both the boats. Like, God, I'm in your boat, and man, I'm with you also. No, you cannot. Hallelujah. Look unto Jesus. Look unto Jesus. Hope in the Lord, and he will fulfill the desires of your heart. His plans are much more greater than you can think. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless you. With these words, let God be your Lord. Hallelujah. Let the Lord be your God. Let money not be your God. Let the hospitals not be your God. Let man not be your God. Let your own flesh be not your God. But let Jesus Christ be your Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless you with these words. Amen.